It has been and still is a hard time for many. But tonight, we turn the page. Tonight, after a breakthrough year for America, our economy is growing and creating jobs at the fastest pace since 1999.
Turn the page refers to ending a particular series of events or a particular situation and to try to make a fresh start, changing direction. It can also be referred to as turning over a new leaf or getting over the past or moving on or letting go. The idea being that someone consciously decides to separate the past from the future and to bring the past to a close and to move on to the future. And as well as being a conscious decision by an individual, it can also be a period of history as well, or a particular event in history. So for example, when World War II ended, the entire world turned a page and started to move on to a new world. Or similarly, when JFK got assassinated, people used that event to separate the old from the new, and they felt that they were completely different time periods before and after that one moment in time. And today, with the war in Iraq originally winding down, the U.S. troops leaving Iraq was considered to be turning the page on the Iraq war. And likewise in Afghanistan, with the troops leaving, they consider that to be turning the page. During World War II, prior to the Battle of the Bulge, the German army was still considered to be very strong, but they used up all of their energy with that one battle, and they were weakened after that, which turned the page on the war and brought about the end stage of the war. Every time the new president gets elected, they promise to turn the page on all of the negativity of the prior president.
And it has been your resilience, your effort, that has made it possible for our country to emerge stronger. We believed we could reverse the tide of outsourcing and draw new jobs to our shores.
Reverse the tide refers to changing a fairly large process that's usually working against you into another large process that's usually working in favor of you. So for example, in a sporting event, a team might be losing by a lot, and then somewhere in the middle of the event, they get a lot of energy and they start making the plays and they're able to turn the tide against defeat. The same goes for armies as well, where one army is originally winning the battle and then the other army is able to turn the tide and to turn the situation around to a positive situation. And can also refer to a company that's not doing very well. For example, Apple Computers, apparently, was on the edge of bankruptcy around 20 years ago or so. But then they brought back Steve Jobs, and they were able to turn the tide against the market influences against them. And now they're the largest company in the world. When Obamacare first got passed, originally, a lot of people weren't signing up, but then when the deadline started to approach, millions and millions of people who never had health care before in their lives signed up for Obamacare, and that reversed the tide against a lot of the negativity against the program. Prior to the mid-50s, polio was a very, very devastating disease for mostly for young people. But then they came up with the polio vaccine, and within a few years, they were able to reverse the tide and diminish the disease, so that nowadays, very few people have to suffer from polio anymore because of the new vaccines.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm feeling chipper tonight. I survived the White House shakeup.
Chipper refers to someone having a very lively, positive attitude. It comes from the idea of birds chirping in the morning when a lot of people would otherwise rather be sleeping. So if someone has a chipper attitude, it just means they're happy and lively. I've been doing an exercise program, and so lately I've been feeling extra chipper. It seems to be working out really well. I went with a friend after work to go buy some flowers for his wife. He's hoping she feels extra chipper when he gets home.
That's all for today. Tom Taylor is an ESL tutor. He teaches English in the United States and outside, all over the world using Skype. He can be reached at his website, which is
ESL-FullSteamAhead.com.
Click on this link and check out his website and email with questions. Thank you, Tom, and I'll talk to you next time.
Thank you.